Hi, I'm Chaplain Larry Spielman. Thanks for taking time to listen to God's Word as it's presented here at the World Equestrian Center. We hope you'll be encouraged in your walk with the Lord. So let's get started. Hi, I'm Chaplain Larry Spielman, and I just want to welcome you here to the World Equestrian Center for another one of our church services. Hey, I have a question for you. Have you ever thought or maybe said, that's the last straw? Thinking that you just can't take it anymore. That's an idiom. And we're in a series right now called Idioms with a Horse. And, we use words that don't always mean what they literally say, but we emphasize a situation or something that we want people to get the message on by using these idioms. And we use them all the time. There's all kinds of them out there. And so the last straw is just an example of what I want to share with you today. You know, before modern times, people transported their goods usually with some kind of an animal. No matter what it was, they would pile it up on them and let them carry it for them, carry their burden for them. And the story goes about the last straw that a rich man used camels to transport his straw. And he would load as much straw as he possibly could on them in order to get the most out of the animal and make the least amount of trips. So one day he proceeded to load the last piece of straw onto the camel's back, and the camel collapsed. And the back had broken, and the man was unable to move any more straw. And so you kind of get the picture here with the last straw. He piled as much on as he could and even went more than he should have and broke the camel's back. And you know what? A lot of times people say this term or this idiom when they're just fed up. They've had enough. They can't take anymore. And they say, that's the last straw. This has broken the relationship, or this has broken my endurance. I can't take anymore. And so we use that last straw quite a bit. And so I think that, you know, these things, as we think about them, the idioms that we use are really interesting how they've developed over the years and where they've come from. Turning to our idiom today, you know, a majority of people in the world have experienced some kind of unexpected blessing or unexpected situation that's been positive for them. And so our idiom today is kind of dealing with that. You may have heard the story of a horse that was named Dream Alliance. His brood mare mother was a bad-tempered horse. She actually had barbed wire injuries. And so she was purchased for a small amount of money. Didn't seem like she had much use anymore. His sire was basically an unknown stallion who had never accomplished a whole much in his career. And so Dream Alliance's story is an interesting one. And his story never would have happened if it hadn't been for a barmaid in South Wales who got the idea that she wanted to breed a racehorse. She had never done that before, never had any experience with racehorses, but she just felt like that was something that she wanted to do. She'd overheard people in the bar where she worked talking about it and thought it would be a good thing. And so she actually, her and her husband, formed a syndicate of about 23 people. They put in 10 pounds a week in order to pay for this colt to be born. And so they raised it and they paid for its training. And this colt, actually, Dream Alliance, actually became a racehorse after a period of time. And so this whole village rallied around this racehorse. Now, in the beginning, nobody took him serious because he didn't have any pedigree. Nobody knew anything about him. He'd show up to the races and that was about it. But eventually he started getting a little more up in the standings. You know, he went from fourth place to third place to second place. And then all of a sudden he won a race. And it was amazing what people thought there that was part of that village. It was an old mining village that was declining. And there wasn't a lot of hope around there. But all of a sudden, this village had hope because of this horse that had been raised from out of nowhere was starting to win at steeplechase races. Now, Dream Alliance didn't have a a long history. As a matter of fact, he was injured, and his injury required him to have stem cell therapy in his leg. And he was one of the first horses to ever have that done. And he came back and even raced again after that, and it was very effective, but then they decided to retire him. But Dream Alliance really lifted this community. He lifted this family's hopes and all of this syndicate people, their hopes up to see that something good could happen in their lives. And so Dream Alliance really became this true dark horse. He was a horse that came from nowhere. Nobody expected him. Nobody knew anything about him. And yet he was able to win races when nobody thought that he could. And I think that today, a lot of times we think about dark horses, and we think about a dark horse, and we think that maybe has some kind of a negative thought to it, because, you know, dark, the dark side, and all of those kinds of things. But the dark horse in this particular situation turned out to be a very good thing. It was just that nobody knew anything about him. Nobody was expecting anything about to come from him. The origins of this expression actually say they go back several years to the 19th century, when there was an American horse owner, and he would take his racehorse and he would go to a village or a town where nobody knew him and just act like that his horse was just a regular old pack animal, and he would enter him into a race. And of course, being a racehorse, he would usually win, and the man would walk away with a lot of money. Well, nobody knew anything about his horse either, and so they called it a dark horse. And so that's kind of where the saying took off from there. It's kind of an amazing thing when you think about a dark horse, nobody knowing, nobody expecting, but all of a sudden something happens, something shows up, some situation changes, and people are taken by surprise because they weren't expecting it. You know, listen to what the Bible says. The Apostle Paul wrote this in Ephesians, and I think it's excellent when we're thinking about unexpected blessings and unexpected situations in our lives. Now, to him who is able to do far more abundantly beyond all that we can ask or think, according to the power that works within us, to him be the glory in the church and in Christ Jesus to all generations forever and ever. Amen. So, God is able to do more abundantly than we can ask or think. He can go far beyond what our expectations are and even surprise us on many levels with blessings that we weren't expecting. And that's the point that I want to bring out today with this dark horse message. God is the author of unexpected blessings. You know, lots of times people are taken by surprise by the things that God does and how he moves in our world. All through the Bible, we find stories where God showed up and changed a person's situation or a person's life completely in an unexpected way. I want to share a passage with you, and it's a little story that I think is really relevant to this whole subject, and it's around the prophet Elijah. And God used him to bring an unexpected blessing to a widow woman. It's in 1 Kings chapter 17. It says, when Elijah came near the town gate of Zarephath, he saw a widow gathering sticks for a fire. Would you please bring me a cup of water, he asked. As she left to get it, he asked, would you also bring me a piece of bread? The widow answered, in the name of the living God, I swear that I do not have any bread. All I have is a handful of flour and a little olive oil. I'm on my way home now with these few sticks to cook what I have for my son and me, and after that, we will just starve to death. Then Elijah said, everything will be fine. Do what you said. Go home and fix something for you and your son. But first, please, make a small piece of bread and bring it to me. The Lord God of Israel has promised that your jar of flour won't run out and your bottle of oil won't dry up before he sends rain for the crops. The widow went home and did exactly what Elijah had told her to do. She and Elijah and her family had enough food for a long time. The Lord kept the promise that his prophet Elijah had made, and she did not run out of flour or oil. Hey, think about this. What a great story. What an amazing surprise this lady got. Here she was telling the prophet Elijah, you know what? I'm going home. I'm taking these sticks that I've gathered up, and I'm going to go home and build a fire, and I'm going to cook this little bit of stuff that I have left. And then after that, my son and I are just going to starve to death because we don't have any hope. There's nothing going to change for us. We're in this situation, and we can't get out. And Elijah said, yeah, let's just think about this for a minute. Let's put God first and let's do what he's said to do and we'll see what happens. And so the story ends with her hearing and understanding that God was faithful to his promise. He brought a surprise into her life that she hadn't expected. Elijah stopped by. Elijah said he had a message from the Lord and he told her exactly what to do. And because she listened to Elijah and followed Elijah's directions, God blessed her with a special surprise. So, it's amazing to see how these impossible situations change when God does something to bring hope and encouragement to people. I hope in your life that there's been times that you can look back on and you can see where maybe you were hopeless in some situations, or maybe a friend of yours or family member, and you just wondered what in the world could happen in this situation. And all of a sudden, there's a surprise blessing. There's a dark horse that comes into their life, something that they weren't expecting at all, that changed everything. I want to tell you today, God can do the impossible. God can do the impossible. You know, the Ohio State motto is, with God, all things are possible. And it's been that motto since 1959. And it happened because a young boy, 12 years old, suggested that that's what Ohio's motto ought to be. There's been a lot of lawsuits. There's been a lot of challenges to it. But over the years, it stood the test of time. Now, I wonder where this 12-year-old boy might have gotten a thought like that. I believe that he got it from the Bible because he knew a God that could do anything, that God was the author of fixing the possible or the impossible into the possible. And today I want you to know God can do anything. If you in the three Gospels, the first three books of the New Testament, if you will read through there, And look at those, you'll see that Jesus is quoted in every one of those three as saying, with man it's impossible, but with God all things are possible. Jesus knew that there wasn't anything that was outside of what God could do. So what kind of impossible situation are you facing today? I just believe today in a miracle-working God. And I know that there's a lot of folks that struggle to wrap their mind around that, to understand that. But God has been working miracles from the beginning of time, and he hasn't stopped working miracles. I've experienced miracles in my life many, many times, watching God do the impossible when I had no idea that it could change, that my situation could change, that God could fix it for me. And it usually came from an unexpected place. And so over and over again in the Bible, we see people with no hope and God shows up. You know, every time in the New Testament that Jesus showed up, the situation changed. No matter how dire or how bad it was, even from providing wine for a wedding that had run out of wine, Jesus stepped up and did what they needed. To healing the most broken people in the world, the sickest people, the most hopeless people, Jesus was able to reach into their lives and touch their bodies many times and give them the healing that they needed. He was also able to bring deliverance to people whose lives were hopeless and they thought that there was no answer for them. And yet Jesus came into the situation. He brought an unexpected miracle and he changed their situation completely. So listen this morning, today, what about you? What about the situation that you're in? Do you need God to bring a dark horse miracle, something unexpected to your life? I like that old statement that people used to say, and they said it pretty often, was we need to expect a miracle. Are you expecting a miracle in your life today? Are you expecting God to show up in some special way, a way that you haven't expected? Maybe we need to turn our expectations around and remember that God is the God of the impossible. God can bring change. God can bring something new, something that we haven't thought about yet in our life. This year has been a tough year, and a lot of folks have experienced a lot of difficult things through this year. And you know what? We're not at the end of the year yet. And I suspect that there are probably a lot of people within the sound of my voice who really could use a miracle today. And I want to encourage you today. I want you to know that God has not forgotten where you are. God has not left you abandoned. God cares. God loves us. God is concerned about us. And He is the God of the impossible. And so I want you to know today, as bad as our situation is in our country and throughout our world, and all the sickness and all of the unrest and all of the violence and all of the things that we are dealing with, God can come in and bring a miracle to your life today. And we should be expecting Him to do just that. I've watched God, as I've said before, I've watched Him come into my life and change situations for me. I've had times that I didn't have a job and I had a family and I wondered, how will I feed my family? And you know what? God always found a way to feed me. As a matter of fact, I've never missed a meal because I didn't have something to cook or eat. I've always had something to eat all of my life because God has taken care of me. You know, the Bible says, I've never seen the righteous forsaken or his seed begging for bread. And I've just believed that all of my life. Anytime I've had a need, God has been there and supplied that for me. Whether it was food or whether it was a job or whether it was a vehicle, whatever it might be, God always supplies what I need in my life. And I trust Him for that. And it's always coming sometimes at an unexpected place. From an unexpected place, a place that I didn't really know that it would happen from. And, you know, a lot of times we just have to take those steps when we feel impressed to go here and follow what God may be speaking into our heart, into our life, to go and follow Him and see what He's going to do, because God is the God of miracles. He's the God of impossibles. So think about that story of the widow today. Hopeless, no food. Her son's going to die. She's going to die. And God steps in and changes everything. And the Bible says that her flour didn't run out and her oil didn't run out until they had crops again from the rain that was coming. See, God knows what we need. We don't have to worry about the fact that God doesn't know. God knows, and He just wants us to come to Him and expect Him, to pray to Him, ask Him, seek Him for what He wants to do in our life. I assume that most people today are ready for a dark horse miracle, something unexpected to show up in their life. And so here's what I want to do. I want to challenge you today to read those first four books of the New Testament and watch how God did things in an impossible way. Follow Jesus as He touched people and healed people. Follow Jesus as He fed multitudes of people. Follow Jesus through those first four books. And I know that the Lord will speak to you in that time in His Word of following Him and seeing all of the unexpected blessings that He brought to the world through Jesus' ministry. And then take your impossible situation to God. Take it to Him in prayer and ask Him today to give you the miracle that you need, because that's what prayer is all about, just talking to the Lord and telling Him what you need. Expect Him to move on your behalf. And then make sure that you have a relationship with Him. And really, you know, having a relationship with God is just about asking Him for forgiveness, asking Him to come into your life and lead you as your guide and director. We call it Lord. He's the one who controls the things that we do from that time forward. And so trust Him for His salvation, trust Him for His forgiveness, and then ask Him to give you a miracle. Ask Him to provide those things that you aren't able to get on your own. You know, here's the thing that I believe. I believe when we come to the extent of ourselves, we come to the end of our rope. That's just the time that God's willing to pick up the rope and help us and see that He's still active and moving in our world, in our lives. God wants to make a way for His people. He is looking for opportunities in each one of our lives to be that dark horse provider, that blessing that maybe that we haven't expected. So it probably won't happen just exactly the way that you think it ought to. But if I know God like I've always known God to act, He moves in ways that are always helpful and always best for us. And so today, when you're thinking about that dark horse, you're thinking about that dream alliance, that dark horse that won those races and came out of nowhere, I want you to know today, maybe God is going to bring something into your life that comes out of nowhere, someplace that you can't imagine that it could come from. And God brings a special person or a special situation or a special provision into your life to meet your need. I want to pray for you today, and let's trust God together for something new, something unexpected in your life today. Father, I thank you that we have the opportunity to expect the best, expect a miracle, expect change when we come to you in prayer. God, we know that you are the God of impossible. You can do things that are way beyond our belief. Lord, things that everyone else would discount and say could never happen, God, you can make them happen. And God, today, we're just lifting up those who are watching, those who are even praying right now and asking you, God, to bring change into their life, to help them in whatever the situation is. God, we pray that right now that your hand would be upon them, that you would touch them, that you would draw them close to you and help them to know that you have their needs, God, that you can meet their needs right now. I pray, Lord, if they're not in a relationship with you, that they would ask you right now for your cleansing, healing power in their lives and in their souls, and that they could have forgiveness today. Lord, that they could establish a relationship with you. God, bless them today. We just thank you so much for all that you do in our life. Thank you for the surprises that you're going to bring, because God, we just know that as we trust you, you do new and great things every single day. We bless you and honor you today. In Jesus' name, amen.